Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to the Silent Age. We are continuing with the story. The next chapter ahead of us is Chapter 5, The Corpse. Now, inside the hospital, Joe hopes to find the time traveler and hopefully learn more. In case you guys have not been following along, essentially, Joe finds the time traveler in the basement of the secret laboratory basement of the organization that he works for, and he's handed a time travel device and promptly arrested after that because of complications, which are yet unclear, but uses the time travel device to head to the future and finds a way to escape the police station. And now he's just looking for the guy who handed him the time travel device. He just wants to check up on that guy. And given the title of this chapter, I'm pretty certain that the guy is dead. So otherwise, why would they call it a corpse? Anyhow, I honestly, if I hit continue and restart, it should be the same, but I will just hit continue and restart instead. Chapter 5, The Corpse. We are in the future right now. There's a corpse here, obviously. This is the remains of the ambulance driver, or a mechanic. It's impossible to tell, really. Poor guy. I guess I can set them making engine noises with my mouth while imagining I'm going somewhere really fast. There's a button here which obviously won't do anything. There's no power, right? The garage door. It's electrical and electricity is long gone. Let's explore a little, let's figure out what the issue is that we need to take care of. Tire iron. We do have a tire iron here. Okay, a small hospital, not too large. This one's locked. What about room B there? They're both locked. Alright. There's also this window here. It's cleared up. It will get dark in a few hours though. I better get going. Alright. Time to head to the present. Office door. It is apparently locked, and I'm guessing it's the same for this one as well. Nope, it opens. Alright, let's check out the office. Even though the soundtrack is very ominous, it's... Honestly, this game doesn't really have a lot of quick time events or anything. It's just a regular lamp. Nothing special about it. E. Another E. Another E. 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 It's an E. They should really mix up the letters. They're way too easy to cheat on these tests. Flip calendar. It's today's date, Monday, May 17th. Anyhow, let's just drawers are stuck, but I can't imagine what I need in there anyway. There's a lung chart, there's a trachea chart, this is an probably a pulmonary doctor's place. Office. File cabinets, bingo. These are patient files, and of course the cabinet's locked. Well, we can't exactly open it up using a tire iron, so. Sometimes I wonder if that's how doctors actually see people. Looks like an upside down tree of some kind. Which isn't entirely inaccurate, if you ask me. Let's look out the window and see if there's anything different. It's cleared up. And here is the garage that we saw initially. Hospital lobby. Okay, there's a way into the lobby as well apparently. It's locked. Let's go in there and head into the future. Sorry, into the past. There's a car battery here.
Ouch!
Ouch! There's still juice left in this battery. There's a button here that can be used to essentially open the car. Looks like someone's changing the tire. If I can just find some tools to finish the job, this ambulance could prove really useful. I see what you're doing there. Handyman. It's ready to go, I just need the time traveler's address. What about the battery though? Does it not need to be in the ambulance? Let's just open the door up. Make things easy on ourselves. The garage door is open now. I won't get far on foot. Getting here was hard enough, and that was barely a block and a half. It's locked, of course it is. Alright. We are headed into the future, and this door is now open in the future, so we can head in and see things for ourselves. Since we apparently opened it in the past, and nothing's changed since then. It's full of medical mumbo jumbo and words like hematology, growth rate, pandemic, and a note that says, "I took your stapler, be even now, asshole, Dr. Phelps." It's just another regular lamp, nothing there. A dirty calendar with no date on it. Man, that's thirsty. Okay, so it's basically on the same day. The apocalypse literally happened on that same day. So, it's like the floor, it looks like the floor caved into the weight of the desk. That's one heavy desk, I would say. Gaping hole in the floor. Really? You let me go down through there? Oh well. I found some scissors.
Ow!
They're still remarkably sharp, so you probably should not be cutting yourself on equipment inside of hospitals, son. It's a skeleton. Nothing but a pile of bones and strips of clothing. Well, that's an accurate representation of a skeleton, if you would ask me. It's just a worn lamp. Downstairs office. Broken x-ray board. Glass is broken, but the bulbs seem to work fine. I wonder if they still work. If only the power wasn't out. Well, I guess that's what the batteries are for then.
Wow.
Oh, there's a key there. I'm guessing that's the key to the office number B. It's a key. A little small to be a door key. Maybe it's for a padlock or a locker of some kind. I guess. Ordinary wall lamp, which does not work anymore. And I'm guessing there's no way here. Or here. So I suppose this is the point, maybe. Human remains, let's inspect them, nonetheless. It's so freaky. 1 minute he's alive, the next he's a pile of bones. Ain't that the truth? Oh shit. Seems very focused on whatever he's busy with. I better not disturb him. It's locked from the outside. I don't want to think about why that's necessary. Let's go inside and switch back to the present. I just want to quickly check something out. Oh no, that's the time traveler's body. Reginald Lambert. Lambert, no address. They probably don't put stuff like that on these tags. It has a file number 2. If I can find this guy's medical file, I should be able to get his address. I see. That's the time traveler. Full of weird things in them. Just full of weird things in them. He's dead. It was a long shot, but I kinda hoped he had somehow survived. There's only one way to get answers now, I guess. I need to find out where he lives. Well, lived. Yes, let me take that name tag. Yeah, I was thinking that it might just be necessary. Of course it's locked. Dust drawer, I wonder if it has anything. There's a key in here. It's a car key, it looks like it's one for... It's for one of the ambulances. I have no idea why a doctor would keep a spare key in his desk, but I'm not complaining. Neither should you. Alright, let's go up to the hallway then. I don't think we have explored. Oh, we have. Okay, that was the hallway. It was not Office B, it was literally just the hallway. I wonder why they've labeled it as... Oh, I guess this is a sort of downstairs office. Anyhow, time to get... the file. This guy's file, and I suppose that would complete this chapter. A pretty short chapter. Perfect fit, it's open now. These are patient files, alright. Too bad they still have file numbers and not names. I need the right number to find this file. 49102, we just got the...
Nice!
Jackpot, Lambert's medical file. It has an address on it. 1 Insular Grove, Lake. Schurkte? Yeah, I couldn't read the rest. Excuse me there. So something I want to quickly check is what happens if I go to the hospital lobby. The officer is still questioning that guy right in the lobby. I can hear them through the door. Alright. Means we don't get to go in there? Fine, we'll have to hop to the future just to get in. And hop back to the past. So that we can use the ambulance keys with this.
Here, out on the road, everything seems so normal. Same moon, same night sky. After an hour of driving, it's easy to forget all about that dead world back there. How could Lambert have survived, though? If he came from the future, how did he not die along with everybody else? I just saw his body in the morgue. Now I'm driving out to talk to him alive. How does that work? Do you just leave a copy of yourself every time you use the box? Is that it? Are there copies of me all over the place now? What if he's not there? What if I changed something and he's not alive at all? Maybe all of this has been completely pointless. Maybe there's nothing I can do after all. Maybe these will be my last days, along with everybody else's. Ugh, the thought ties my stomach in knots. No, I better just not think about it and carry on. Did I bring enough gas? God, I hope I brought enough gas.
And that was that for Chapter 5, The Corpse. The next time we come back, we will be covering Chapter 6, The Island. But until then, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. It was a short but sweet level. I mean, I don't recall there being as many chapters when the game first came out back in, I think, 2012 or 13, sometime around that time. I played it back then. And it only had, like, I think it was divided into three chapters back then. I'm not certain, though. And I suppose they split it out into 10 different chapters just for the PC release, and as a result, some of the levels are longer than the others, some of them are far shorter. So, yeah, I mean, it is what it is. Anyhow, when we get back, we will be covering Chapter 6, The Island. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow orphans.